Welcome to this brief guide on how to import a quiz into Microsoft Forms. Microsoft Forms is a great tool for being able to deliver quizzes and questionnaires inside your hybrid meetings. Microsoft Forms has gotten a brand new feature that allows you to import an existing quiz directly into Forms. Here you can see my Word document where I've got my questions and I've got the answers for each question. These are multiple choice with obviously only one correct answer. There's question two as well. And lastly, what I've done is I've saved the file. I've made sure to name it. In this case, I've named it Trivia Quiz. And the file is saved inside my OneDrive. Now, what I'm going to do is I will just simply close down Word. This is important because the file needs to be closed in order for Forms to be able to access it. So now I've opened up Microsoft Edge and I've headed to forms.office.com. Once I'm on the Forms homepage, I have quick buttons to be able to create a new form or a new quiz. Normally I would have created a new quiz and then had to copy and paste all my questions and answers in. But now we have a brand new button called Quick Import. Selecting the Quick Import button will give me a pop-up which will ask me to import my file. This can be a Word document or a PDF, but note that there is a 10 megabyte file size limit, so larger PDFs may be too large. Selecting the Upload from this device option will open up File Explorer, at which point I can select my trivia quiz document. I've also got a PDF, I could use either of these versions of the document. So I select my .docx file and select OK. It'll ask me, do I want to import it as a form or as a quiz? In this instance, I need it to be a quiz because each question will be worth 1 point, etc. And then this will automatically then upload my document and do the conversion into a Microsoft form for me. Please note this is happening in real time, but depending on the size of your document and the speed of your internet connection, this may vary in time. Once done, we simply select Start Review, and that will take us into the editing page for our brand new trivia quiz. Here you can see I've got my questions and it's automatically registered all of my four options as different options. But what I will need to do is use the Review Quiz option here and make sure I add in the correct answers and the point values for each question. So selecting that, I can then open up the different options and select which is the correct option and dictate how many points that question is worth. I also have the option to check whether or not the question is required and also if the question has multiple answers. And then I'll just do another couple just to show this again. So I select Zoe Deschanel. Whoops, I may have forgotten to enter in the number of points there. I'll come back to that. So then I'll go into the third one. There we go. And we'll just add in a couple more points just for our demonstration here. Now, when I scroll back up to the top, you'll notice that the name of the quiz is Trivia Quiz. It's pulled this from the title of the actual document file that I imported, but I want to change this. So I'm going to type in that this is Productivity Paul's Awesome Trivia Quiz. And then I can put in a description if I'd like to. I'm going to say, you know, it's awesome. I mean, it has to be, it's in the title. And so now I've done all of the main edits that I need to do to my quiz. I can then choose if I'd like to dictate a theme to the document. And then I can also select the preview option to get a quick preview of what my quiz will look like when people click on the link that I will send them in order to be able to complete the quiz. Once I've done verifying it in the preview mode, I can simply select the back option and that will take me back to the editing pane should I need to make any changes. And then I select the collect responses button in the top corner to be able to get my link to share this form in either my Teams meeting or however else I need to. And that is how you import a document into Microsoft Forms. I hope you found this tip useful and it saves you time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.